Hi, I'll try to be quick so as not to delay lunch. I'm Evangelos and I'm working at the Institute of Marine Biology, Biotechnology and Aquaculture in Crete. And what you will see here is much louder. Okay. So, and what you will see here is where we stand after many years of collaboration on projects similar to also to the talk you saw before. Can you hear me now? No, it's perfect. Okay. The idea is how we can use closed concept discovery, like when we can calculate the relationships between A to B and C to B, try to find indirect relationships between two entity types, and do that based on information available in the PubAnnotation annotation, or information that we aim to bring into the PubAnnotation annotation. The motivation for this comes from microbial data set analysis. So last October we had a very nice course given in Copenhagen, and it was meant for metagenomic analysis experts, and it was combining both standard metagenomic analysis and also result interpretation based on text mining. This is a slide I just got from the Facebook page of the Integrated Microbial Genomes. Dr. Nico Kirpidis just posted this next week. It's just showing us the trend, the number of metagenome data sets in the Integrated Microbial Genomes resource. And you can see sequencing is going high in terms of efficiency, and it's going low in terms of price. And that's what you see the result here. More and more metagenomes coming that needs to be analyzed and interpreted. In a standard analysis, you get your sample. Here is a water sample. You get the DNA sequences out of it, and then you do, for example, a community composition analysis, which microbes are there, or you do also function. What is the function of the genes found in that sample? However, it is becoming more and more clear that even if you have these results, you still have to look into the literature. For example, if you have some microbes that occur in a patient sample, if you don't know these microbes, how do they perhaps relate with that disease? So the idea is if you can connect these two via other concepts like the genes, tissues, or chemicals. So to keep things a bit simpler for the context of the hackathon, an idea is to work on the Crohn's disease and a microbe that is coming up, Staphylococcus aureus, and for example, link it via genes that are significantly associated with both. We build on previous work on text mining software, but also on BLA, like in 2 years ago, making the results of the Jensen Lab Dagger, bringing them into the PubAnnotation annotation format. And speaking about the Dagger, here is perhaps the quickest way to see graphically a result of its capabilities. So you can annotate in the tag all sorts of entity types like proteins, chemical compounds, species names, environment types, tissues, diseases, or phenotypes. What you see here is a result of the full page tagging via the extract tool. And actually, it's not a tool, it's an ecosystem of tools, because there are different tools developed by different people corresponding to the different entity types or to different concepts. The work from the Institute of Marine Biology is primarily here on bridging what we learn from the way of working in biomedicine into the biodiversity and ecology research. And in relevance to the Crohn's disease and Staphylococcus aureus topic, I would like to get the abstracts that are related to these two concepts, include, besides the species names and the diseases, other entity types that can be tagged by the tagger, and perform queries that can do some of this association analysis, and compare with data we have from existing systems. You saw in the previous talks by Alex the disease. There is also the organisms web resource that allows you to perform document retrieval that is taxonomy aware. You have the diseases. For example, you expect to find Crohn's disease highly associated with the NOD2 gene. And Alex explained quite well the commensioning score. So the idea is you have around 41,000 abstracts linked to the Crohn's disease and another 91,000 abstracts linked to Staphylococcus aureus. While they share only 48 abstracts among this, between these two data sets, is to try via indirect entities to find links between the two. That would be the proposal for this hackathon. Thank you.